gentlemen. Thank you for joining us today. My name is, as already mentioned, Ross Tonnes. I am the former Honorary Consul General of Japan in Amsterdam. I've known Eiko for over 20 years. In fact, she used to work for me. We are gathered here to celebrate Eiko in finding her true destiny as a professional artist. It has been a long journey for her in finding this vocation and life since leaving Japan. Pater van Deel, Jacques and Ada Henkes are Eiko's teacher for her art history study as well as paintings. Manu, Chris and Hannes are long-term best friends of Eiko and supported Eiko in finding her way to becoming an artist. Manu did an exhibition here last year. Therefore, it is a privilege for me to say a few words to congratulate Eiko, Chris and Hannes in their achievement as individual artists. In fact, Chris believed in Eiko's talent as a painter since the time that Eiko and Chris studied together at the Rietveld Academy. As a former Honorary Consul General of Japan, I have been promoting and celebrating our two countries' friendship established since the VOC ships arrived in Japan in 1600. And the Japanese have been connected now for 400 years with us. Today, through this artistic event, our friendship can be further strengthened. We thank the Royal Gallery, Emma, the owner and her husband for supporting this event and allowing our national friendship to further develop and mature. Let's now talk a little about the paintings and sculptures we see here today. A few years ago, Eiko met Karel Appel and interviewed him as a journalist in New York. He made a strong impression on her and has influenced her art since. Neo Cobra is Eiko's style and expressionistic way of depicting in her art. If you look at Eiko's paintings and sculptures, you will start smiling. They are vivid and still have a child's spirit in them. She has created her own animation based on her paintings, and this approach she developed when studying for her Master of Arts at George Washington University. She loves oriental dragons, ninja, and animals. All these favorites are expressed in her paintings as well as sculptures. Her color and form are free, like her living style, as a free, free spirit. She paints without any strategy or any formal painting techniques. The surface texture of her paintings are a characteristic and unique feature of her imaginative world. Even this texture has a very childlike expression. Her sculptures are simple and smooth, without any decoration and own textures. She has perhaps been influenced by an art professor who told her that simplicity would be her best style, that she should express her art within the matter of speeds. She uses calligraphy brushes in order to paint. She believes that speed is spiritual. Spiritual painting should be expressed within a certain speed. Imaginary world, spiritual world. She loves mystical animals, such as dragons. She always did. She loves animation, such as ninja. Everything becomes animation in her mind and is expressed through her art. In composing her art, she tries to make her mind free from every other effect in order to explore this imaginary world and her adventures in a spiritual domain. This approach develops a story as a verbal world and paintings as a visual world, which are connected with each other only by the poem. When she paints and creates small sculptures, she can make a poem from her painting, from visual to verbal. Her story continues, the journey unfolds. Life is a mystery, but the veil is lifting and the sun shines through. Let's now turn to the paintings of Chris. Cheerfulness, playfulness, Now let's return to the paintings of Chris. Her paintings are very popular. People buy her paintings as even in these times of very, very big crisis. When you see her paintings, you will immediately recognize that they show how beautiful Holland is. there are strong sea waves, blowing wind, cows and people living next to each other and completely interactively. Crisp people in her paintings are often depicted as fat, big people. But in the paintings, they are screaming, "We are not fat, we are not big." However, the gravity of how people move are an indication of how heavy they are and how big they are. This makes Chris's paintings very funny and intriguing. Chris was born in Zaanse. She studied at the Hogeschool Kunsten Utrecht as well as the Rietveld Academy. She also has been a dance teacher. Her objects are sometimes dancing and mostly moving. In her mind, our country is beautifully depicted like a typical and traditional Dutch landscape. Wherever we see her paintings, we can hear those Dutch people communicating with the viewer. The viewers of her paintings are the people. Animal, trees, sea in her paintings are all in the same domain, as if the viewers can talk and dance with the object existing in Chris's paintings. "You are heavy, ladies and gentlemen." "No, we are not heavy." We can hear them screaming at us to deny the fact. That is why we start laughing together between objects and viewers. Hannes Kuiper, Chris's husband, is a well-known artist in Haarlem. He has created sculptures for the Children's Hospital. He has also exhibited at the Frans Hals Museum. His art is again very cheerful. If you view his wooden sculpture, your world will open towards the light. Cheerfulness, playfulness makes life even more fun. Hannes's art is defined as the post cobra. His son is smiling, his form is singing, just like the cobra artists try to explore their feelings in their art. Children love his work. He is also a gifted guitar player. Hannes joined Eiko and Chris at this in this exhibition. Moving to our performing artist, André Martine Pedro is Eiko's hartgeschorgen teacher and a musician. He is a graduate from the Zweling Academy on Old Music. The beautiful instrument we see was built by Mr. Fred Battenhuizen in Haarlem. Chris and Hannes' son-in-law is a jazz pianist who will later give us a beautiful improvisation. Chris and Hannes' daughter is a dance teacher, and she will dance for us later as well. Let me end by hoping that this exhibition deepens and enriches every detail of your life and brings fulfillment. Moreover, may this exhibition bring Holland and Japan closer to each other. Thank you very much. Thank you.